Good morning, friends. Today we will see some algorithms for the generation of objects. As we know, in computer graphics, we are displaying some objects on the screen. These objects can be a circle, it can be a line, it can be a polygon, or various types of curves. So today we will see that how these lines or these curves will be generated or will appear in the screen. As we know that a line consists of two endpoints, and we can say that a line is a sequence of points having some specific finite two endpoints. Whenever we are drawing a line, suppose this is a line, we are directly connecting the two endpoints. But when we are plotting these lines in a computer graphical devices, we are not directly connected them, but we have to select the nearby pixels. Suppose this is a line in a coordinate system. As we know that in a computer graphics, we are considering the screen of a device as a coordinate system. So before starting with the initial endpoint of a line, we cannot directly connect it to the another point. This pixel, which is the starting point of a line, will select the nearby pixel. Then this nearby pixel will select its another adjacent pixel, and this selection of pixels will finally connect to the endpoint and forms a line. So this is a complete procedure to how to select the nearby pixel to form a line. We are having some algorithm for this. First of all, from the various objects which we are discussing today, we are starting with the line generation algorithms. So today our topic is line generation algorithm. There are various algorithms which we are having for formation of a line in a computer graphical device. But generally, the two important ones are DDA algorithm and Bresenham algorithm. These two line generation algorithms are based on some formulas through which we are selecting the pixels. In DDA algorithm, which is called digital differential analyzer, this is the basic algorithm for the generation of a line. Okay, we will start with this algorithm, DDA algorithm. Before discussing any algorithm for generation of line, we should consider some points for a line generation. First one is that a line should be always a straight line. Second, the consistency of the line should be consistent. Third, the brightness and the other properties of the line should be same. So considering these points, we are starting with DDA algorithm for the line generation. In this algorithm, we are starting with the first point. Suppose I'm having a line having two endpoints A and B. So we are having the coordinate of these points x1, y1 and x2, y2. So I have to generate a line between these by forming these two endpoints. So we will see the steps which we will follow to generate a line using this. First, step one, consider the two endpoints. We are having the two endpoints A, which is x1, y1. And B, which is x2, y2. In second step, we will find out the differentiate between them. So del x equals to x2 minus x1 and del y equals to y2 minus y. Now in step 3, we will find out that whether the del x is greater than del y. If del x is greater than del y, then we will consider a value variable which I am calling a step. You can call it a step or length or any other. I am calling this a step. Then step is equals to del x. Else, that is, if del y is greater than del x, then our step is equals to del y. So we have found it there. After that, we will find the incremented value of x. We will find out x incremented and y incremented, which will be del x by step and del y by step. Step is considered, as we have seen, that step, the value of step will depend on whether the del x is greater than del y and del y is greater than del x. After finding out them, now in step 5, we are finding out x is equals to x1 plus 0.5 sine and y equals to y1 plus 0.5 sine. Here we are considering sine for the coordinate systems, that in which coordinate your coordinates are lying. If we are in this, then x and y both will be positive. According to this, we will find out the value. And 0.5 is for the considering the integer value of the x and y coordinates. As we know that in DDA, we will consider only the integer value. So we have to consider the absolute values and change them to convert them into the integer value. Now, the final step. We are considering I equals to 1. And we will increase this incremented value up till y I is lesser than equals to steps. This means our increments will be goes up to steps. Suppose our value is 4, then we will have a value 1, 2, 3, 4, and our algorithm will be stop. X is equals to x plus. First, we have to plot this initial values. Then x is equals to x plus del x and y is equals to y plus del y. Both the values of x and y are changing their values according to the calculated differentiated value. And this will be move on up till we will get I is lesser than equals to step. So this is our complete algorithm for our DDA. First we will see a numerical for understanding of this algorithm. After that we will consider one numerical which is come in earlier exams of a UGC NET. So starting with one algorithm. So one numerical is this. Consider A consider the endpoint of a line A and B. A is 0, 0 and B is having a coordinates 4, C. Now rasterize this line using DDA algorithm. This same question comes in a category of rasterize this line using the Bresenham's algorithm. Right now we are seeing it with the help of a DDA algorithm. So how we will calculate or how we will find the number of iterations or the values we will plot for formation of this line. Okay, so considering by step, first we will find out we are having x1 equals to 0, y1 equals to 0. X2 equals to 4 and y2 equals to 6. Now in step 2, we have found it out the value of differential values, that is your del x and del y. So here del x is equals to x2 minus x1, which is 4 minus 0 equals to 4, and del y, y2 minus y1, which is 6 minus 4, 6 minus 0 equals to 6. So we have found out del x and del y. Now our step 3 was find out whether del x is greater than del y or whether del y is greater than del x. Here we are having del y is greater than del x. So our step is equals to value of del y, which is 6. So we can say the number of iteration which we are starting from I equals to 1 will go up to the 6. Now after finding this, we will find out x increments and y increment, which was x increments equals to del x 4 by step and y increment del y by step. So this will be 4 by 6 is equals to 0.666, and you can write it this 6.0.67, and 6 by 6 is equals to 1. So these are our x increments and y increments. Now we will find out the value of x. So our initial value is equals to, we know the formula, x is equals to x1 plus 0.5 into sine, and y equals to y1 plus 0.5 to sine. So x is equals to x1, x1 was 0, so 0 plus 0.5 into sine. We will directly consider the value, positive or negative. We know that x increment is positive, so directly I am writing here positive. Same here, y equals to 0 plus 0.5 into sine. This was also positive. This means that we will get the directly the value x equals to 0.5 and y equals to 0.5. So these are our the first initial points we have calculated. Now we will directly plot the table through which we will get to the iterations starting from 1 to the 6. So iteration pixel x, y and roundabout values of rx and iy. This is your choice, you can write it down and you can directly use them. So iteration is, initially our value is 0.5 and 0.5 which we have calculated. So pixel value starting with 1. Roundabout value of 0.5 and 0.5 is 0, 0. So our first pixel position will be 0, 0. Now we will directly to the step, last step, we will increment these values up to we will get the iteration number 6. So I am directly writing down the values of first x is equals to 0.5 as our initial value is this, plus del x, del x was (coughs) 0.66 x increment. Similarly, y equals to 0.5 plus y increment, which was your 1. So we will get the value 0.5 plus 0.66. You will get the value of 1.67 and 1.5. So roundabout value is 1 and 1. So our next iteration 2, we are having pixel 1, 1. We will increase this process or further produce this process up to the 6 iterations. So next time 1.67 plus 0.66, we are getting 1.833, and 1.5 plus 1, this will be 2.5. So next values are 1 and 2. Now third iteration, we are having plotting 1, 2, this, and the values are 2.5 3.5. so your values will be 2 and 3. So this was the iteration and how the step we have followed. I have solved up to the 3, and the complete solution up to the iteration 6 is here. After the 3, you are incrementing the value of 1, and each time you are incrementing the x and y value with the addition of delta x and delta y. These are the iteration values, then you are rounding off, and you will continually this process up till you will get the iteration 6, because we are having a condition I will move to the 1 to the 6. So this is the how a DDA algorithm will rasterize the points starting from the starting point to the end point and select the nearby pixels. Now we will see a numerical question which comes this year in UGC NET, November 2017. We will solve that problem. The question was this: consider a line AB with A 0, 0 and B 8, 4. These are the coordinates of the endpoint of the line, and they are saying that apply a simple DDA algorithm and compute the first four plots on this line. Here are the options. First option is 0, 0, 1, 1, 2, 1 and 3, 2. B 0, 0, 2, 1. This is the question which comes in the paper 3 of the UGC NET November 2017. They are saying they are having endpoints A and B 0, 0 and B 8, 4, and you have to apply a simple DDA algorithm and compute the first four plots. They are not saying about the whole iterations which we will get. They are asking the initial four iterations. Maybe this iteration is only having a four values, and it can be more than four, but they are asking only about the first four plots on this line. And in the options, you are having the four iterations. So we will see this, we will solve this and find out. So we are having x1 is equals to 0 and y1 is equals to 0. x2 equals to 8 and y2 equals to 4. So applying the DDA algorithm step by step, we will calculate. This was the step 1, then we have found out delta x and delta y. So del x is 8 minus 0. And del y will be 4 minus 0. So your values are 8 and 4. Then you have to find out whether del x is greater than del y. Here we are having del x is greater than del y. So our step, which is a variable, will be equals to 8. This means value of I will move from 1 to 8. But he is asking here only the first four plots on the line. We will solve this. After finding this, we will find out which was delta x by step, delta y by step. Delta x is 8. 8 by 8 you will get 1, and delta y is 4 and by 8 equals to 0.5. After this we will find out x and y value. I'm rubbing this. X is equals to x1 plus 0.5 into sine, and y is equals to y1 plus 0.5 sine. This was the formula. Here x is equals to x1 is 0 plus 0.5 into sine. I'm writing directly here, that is positive. Y is equals to y1, which is 0 plus 0.5 into sine positive. So our values are x 0.5 and y 0.5. Now we will directly plot the table as we are having the values, and we have to move up to the only to the four iterations. I, your pixel, initial value of x and y and roundabout values of x and y. So initially x and y are 0.5 and 0.5. We can call this iteration as 0. 0.5 and 0.5 roundabout we will get 0 and 0. Now we are starting with i1. So pixel value is 0, 0. X, next value of x will be previous value 0.5 plus x increment, that is 1.5. And here 0.5 plus 0.5, that will be 1. So roundabout values are 1 and 1. So next 2 is 1, 1, and we are having 1.5 plus 1 will move to 2.5, and 1 plus 0.5 will give you 1.5. So your next values, roundabout values, are 2 and 1. Third, 2, 1, the pixel 2.5 plus 1 we will get 3.5, 1.5 plus 0.5 we will get 2. So our value will be 3 and 2. So these are the four roundabout values, initial values, which we are required. This is your option A. So for that numerical, your answer would be